us a little bit about Jeff Ofori, because I know you did your research on him.
Yeah, 100%. I remember when I watched Jeff Ofori fight the one before Archie Sharp, actually. I know he's beat...
Ooh.
We'll let Hus bring
him in. It's starting already.
Laskowski.
I'm so glad you're here to help me with the pronunciation.
Now, I watched Laskowski box in November on a grassroots show in Rainton in Newcastle. He's a tough fighter.
Ah, yes.
He's not a punching bag. He will club and he will believe that he can win. And he is a good boxer. He will throw as many as you throw. So what you've really got to do against someone like Laskowski is you've got to sting him with the jab. And you've got to make him second guess his movement. The longer the bout goes on, if you don't, he will gain confidence and he will come into the fight.
Now, where were you? Where were you when you were talking about him?
I was talking about the Archie Sharp fight because I actually thought he won that fight.
Really?
Obviously, before that, for those who haven't seen it, go watch him against Zahara Davis. Unfortunately, he got stopped in that fight. But one thing with Jeff Ofori is he always comes to win and he's got a really, really good work ethic. Do you know what I mean? And he throws brilliant combinations to the body, which is quite rare for a boxer. 3-4 punch combinations in close proximity.
Well, the only thing that I've looked at his record, and I know that he hasn't been active since, well, it's been since 2020, when he suffered those losses against Archie Sharp and Ahara Davis. So is he going to have the ring rust? A lot of fighters say, you know what, I didn't believe it until I got in there and the ring rust is real. He's got a lot to prove. He's coming off 2 losses. That psychologically can do a lot to fighters. And this is the importance of the small horse shows, where we get to build them back.
100%. And I think a massive credit to Ofori is after every single time he's took a loss, he's actively said that he's watched the tape over and over again and he's looked for improvements.
Fantastic.
So I'm expecting him to take pressure off himself, to get into his movements and just do what he does.
And this, yeah, and that's what I like to see, because it's not a lot of fighters that would do that and be able to give themselves that self-critique.
He's looked in the mirror and he's been honest with himself and he's looked to improve, and that's how a fighter gets better. So.
Oh, we're still nattering on while they're doing the announcing. Sometimes we can be so rude.
We can, yeah. I'm excited for this one because this is the perfect springboard for Ofori to come off those losses. Like I said, Laskowski is not a pushover. Do you know what I mean? So you don't want, for a fighter that is of his level, his Southern Area English level, in my opinion, this is the perfect fight to springboard him back to those big platforms.
Well, we'll definitely see if he's been watching back his videos and learning from his fights on how he deals with this. But here we go. We crack on into round one. And straight away, the pole takes the center of the ring, but Ofori's not having it. I like his guard, actually. He's got the right hand ready for the parry. The glove is facing outwards. It's like it's ready to parry and counter. Oh, okay. And his timing's quite good. The pole's just thrown a shot, and he's just literally stepped out of the way.
It's interesting because he's not hardly thrown anything, but he's got Laskowski guessing already.
Yeah.
And I find that fascinating in boxing, how body language can affect an opponent like that.
And
it can force them to make mistakes without you throwing the shot, which I think is very clever.
Yeah. We just saw Ofori throw a nice 1-2 there and literally slip out of the way of an uppercut that came back from his opponent. He seems quite tidy, compact, Ofori. What do you think?
I do, and I think he throws short, quick combinations, which I think is very, very, it's hard when you're boxing someone like that. Do you know what I mean? Oh, it's a good variation to the body there. It was a beautiful body shot.
Nice stiff jab from Ofori.
It's sort of like a semi-hook he throws, isn't it, to put his opponent
yeah.
on?
Yeah. Often described as a range finder. Well, you tap with the hook, and then you throw the backhand. I haven't seen him do that yet.
Everything comes off it, yeah.
You saw him about to throw an uppercut there, but Ofori almost hesitated. You can see he doesn't really want to waste his shots. He wants to hit him with power. I'm not sure if he's looking for a knockout here, or is this his style?
From what I've seen, this is his style. And I think he's a very precise puncher as well. It's a lovely right hand, that was.
Yeah, he's definitely accurate with his punches.
One.
Yeah, he's not wasting any shots at all.
And what's interesting here is,
for
the viewers watching this, who've probably heard me talk about Laskowski, they probably thought I was lying, but Ofori's fighting a very clever fight here. He's making him guess. And he's really not sure what to throw.
Yeah, but you can see he's still relentless. He's still giving it a go. Yet again, another opponent that's not come here to just stand and take the shots. But yet again, Ofori, just his timing, his accuracy, the way he lands them. There's no wasting here.
And I think the body language as well, it's really clever the way he's pressuring a fighter. He's just moving forward, making him feel uncomfortable, and then just making him miss, and he's going to pay for it.
Yeah, we're definitely seeing some IQ here. Sometimes you think, I don't know, right, okay, they're both throwing the combinations here. Round one, that's a quick 3 minutes.
It's an interesting opening round because Laskowski threw a hell of a lot more punches than Ofori did, but he was on the back foot a lot. And I think Ofori, if he can put this together round by round, I think we might see something good here.
You can see he's quite cool and calm in the corner, talking to his coach. Almost smiled at him at one point. He seems quite relaxed, quite comfortable, quite happy that he's back in there.
Yeah, you can see the chemistry between fighter and coach.
You can see his opponent getting some tips, telling him about his feet by the looks of it. But I do like the fact that Ofori doesn't use up a lot of energy. He's not jumping and skipping around the ring. A very pro style he's got.
Exactly, and that's something that you need when you go up the levels as well. We've seen with lots of different boxers, you can't box like the amateurs and the pros. You've got to find that IQ, that precision.
They're both straight in there. It's a battle of the jabs at the moment. Ofori is throwing a nice right hand, pressuring him into the corner.
That was a nice combination.
Yep. Laskowski was on the ropes momentarily. He's swinging and missing.
I think he's trying to gain Ofori's respect here because he's throwing some wild shots. I think he's trying to connect
just so he
doesn't edge him back.
Yeah, it's definitely not happening.
But credit to Ofori, he's right in his face and he's just patient.
Yeah, he is. Very patient.
Look how close he is and look how patient he is.
And he still can't get him. Laskowski being the longer range fighter. And he's just right in there. Ofori's just right in there.
It's nice movement there.
Calculated, timed, got him against the ropes. He's looking for the shots. He's looking. You can look at that.
What I like is the variation. He sort of pulls his right hand back like he's going to hit him in the face. And then he throws it to the solar plexus.
He did, but Laskowski got him with a nice hit to the side of the head there, where Ofori kind of like nodded at him, like to say, yep, okay, you got me there. He's just thrown a nice short uppercut.
Yeah, it's like he was feeling them out.
Oh, this is beautiful. Now we're starting to see the work. Ofori's starting to throw the combinations. He's starting to work his opponent now. Hands are dropping. Hasn't got time to put his hands back up.
And you can hear the corner say, when you've got him, keep working.
He might stop him. Let's have a look. He's throwing those uppercuts. Laskowski's coming back with a jab.
But you can see Laskowski's breathing heavier now.
He is. Oh, absolutely beautiful right hand.
He ate that right hand again.
Beautiful. But look, his balance is off. It's hurting him. He's hurt.
I'm really impressed with the patience here from Ofori.
Yeah, I like
it. A lot of fighters at this level would really be throwing the kitchen sink at him.
Yeah,
though.
And he's just so calm.
And he's comfortable, look.
Yeah,
he's
right
in punching range and he's very comfortable. He's just making a miss.
I really like the uppercut that he throws. He's just done it again. Look at it. He's done that three times, an uppercut into his opponent. There you go again. It's that uppercut. It's beautiful. He looks for it. He's got his opponent on the ropes.
I mean, to say that you said he was out of the ring for quite a while, he doesn't really seem like there's much
ring rust here.
I can't
see any ring rust here at all. Laskowski's breathing heavy. I don't know how many more of those uppercuts he can take, but that seems to be the shot that Ofori's going for. He just leans into him, puts the shoulder in, and throws the uppercut. Once again, got him off balance. The corner's already getting ready to come to Laskowski's rescue.
It's just like his other fights that I've watched as well. He's got a good variety.
Yeah.
And that's a good boxer, because your opponent's going to keep guessing and think, where are you going to go? Are you going to hit the uppercut? Are you going to hit that left hook? Are you going to go to the body? And that's where the openings come, because your opponent feels like, it's like a chess match. They feel like they've got to throw before you throw.
Yeah, well, he definitely won that round comfortably. I'd say that's more than a confident comeback for him.
And if we watch back there, there's a nice right hand on us. You can see how focused Jeff is in the corner here, look. Just looking at his coach. And it's just that understanding of he knows exactly what he needs to do. And he's not even breathing heavy.
That's what I mean.
He's not breathing heavy at all.
He's boxing clever. Oh, the ref gave him a little bit of a warning about below the belt. I don't know if I saw that myself, but okay.
It's a nice left of the body, then the hook. And again.
Yeah, I think the ref gave him a little stare again. See, he's hitting him with some good body shots, but I really like the way that he holds his hand in that parry position, ready to parry the shot. Laskowski's just clinching. Once again, he's out of the clinch, and Ofori throws that uppercut.
To me, there's the odd moment where he's waiting a little bit too long in front of his opponent. So in them higher levels, you are going to get punished for that.
Yeah.
But I think it's just really comfortable with the opposition that he's fighting against here. And he's just read him like a book.
But it could get to the point, like you said, if he does rely on the one shot, the opponent has the IQ to be able to read what he's going to do. You can hear the coach saying, attack him to the body. Okay, and he's going straight for the head. Before he's getting in with some good shots.
It's that sneaky little uppercut that comes in there after the right to the body, doesn't it?
Yeah, the 1-2 and then the uppercut. This is a proper battle. They're both going at it here. Laskowski's not sitting down, is he?
I told you, Laskowski comes to win every time.
Hitting him with some nice powerful shots.
It's like a
shots.
Short uppercut, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
And it's thrown at that angle as well.
There's some blood coming from the nose of... can you pronounce his name?
Laskowski.
Laskowski. I am terrible. Yeah, he's done some damage. There's some blood. He's wiping his nose. Laskowski, that is.
And it's interesting, before Jeff throws, he's just looking for the openings, isn't
he?
He's just seeing, where is the space? Can I get behind the back of the elbow? Can I hit the solar plexus?
Yeah,
can I sneak that left into the fit? Do you know what I mean?
He's finding the angles. He's looking for it. Nose is starting to bleed a bit heavy now. Here we go. They're both leaning to each other and some trading going on. Before he's throwing that uppercut, Laskowski's taking a step back.
He's pushing him back now.
Yeah. But he's still coming in with the counters. He's not easy to put away, is he, Laskowski?
He's tough. And this is what prospects need. They need tough journeymen and respect to the journeymen for going in there and taking these.
Yeah, but we've watched fights and we've seen opponents come back after, you know, a break.
This is what they need. They need someone to trade back with them. Yeah, this is what you're going to get at the high levels. So.
Yeah, but I'd say Ofori is doing a really good job. If you said to me he fought on the last Boxing High show in November, I would have agreed with you. He doesn't look like he's had any time out, let alone 2 years. So I think he should be really proud of what he's done.
Yeah, and I think if he was sat with us right now, he'd be telling us that he's been ticking over in the gym nicely. He's not taking a break off, so huge credit to him.
It looks like he's been getting the sparring in. Definitely a good competitive round, but I'm going to say Ofori is definitely
doing the do.
It's just his style. I like his style.
And that's one thing with Ofori, you're always going to get an exciting fight.
Yeah, I wish him all the best back on his journey. I think we're going into the final round now, because this fight has just literally flown. Touch gloves, it's the last round.
I think I heard the trainer saying set pace on him now, so I think they might be stepping it up this round a little bit.
Yeah, just to secure a points win.
Oof. It's a nasty uppercut on the inside, that was.
But Lukowski's counter-punching back.
And that right to the body has been there all night long. You can see a little bit of redness on the ribs as well.
Yeah, he looked like he had a cut on his head at one point as well. The nice jab and a slip. Laskowski's trying to use his strength to clinch and push him back. I'd say it's a convincing win, but like I said, how long are we left? We've got a couple of minutes left in this last round. He's got to put that work in. I thought he was going to get him out of there at one point. What did you think?
I just think he's getting the rounds in. I think when you've been out for a couple of years, the most important thing is to get the rounds in, especially when he's clearly above this level, isn't he? So I can see him going on for English and British titles. And I think it's important to get the rounds in, to be honest.
Yeah. He's got good timing and he's able to avoid him. That's, you know, Laskowski, that's got longer arms, a better reach. And he's able to stay just in range, but able to avoid the shots as well. I like that about him.
It's interesting because Laskowski usually gives prospects a really hard time with his work rate. He gets on top of you, he throws combinations, and the prospect feels like, God, I've got to really put it on him here to get this win. And I think what's interesting is what I said earlier in the bout, is Jeff's not thrown as much as Laskowski. Well, he is now,
he's starting to throw the shots now. He's not holding back now.
It's a big finish now.
Yeah, definitely. He's tend to keep going. You hear the coach saying, keep going, don't stop. And this is what we want, don't switch off, just keep going, win the round. He had a bit of a flurry and he stopped.
I can see him being a really fun favourite fighter.
Yeah. Needs to push him back. That's it. Throw some shots, more shots into him. There we go.
I mean, huge credit to Laskowski. He's a tough, tough man here.
Yeah, his head's going to be hurting him tomorrow morning, though, because he's took some shots.
A little bit of bleeding on the middle of the nose there as well.
Yeah. I thought he had a cut to the top of his head, but maybe that was just some of the blood splatter. It looks like he's bust his lip as well. Last 10 seconds. That was a good bout. That was a good return bout.
It's like I said, if you've been out for 2 years, that's the perfect opponent to come back to. You don't want somebody that's a punching bag that you're chasing around the ring, that's covering up, that's negative. You want someone that's going to come to the middle of the ring with you and is going to make you work. He's going to make you show your level. He's going to make you show your IQ. And I think that was perfect for Ofori then.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's see what the scores at the doors are for this. Waiting for the announcement on the win. I'd say it's a good win by Ofori. And then we're going to hand over to our lovely Melissa that's doing the presenting for the post-fight interview.
He's just looked over at the commentary and he looks a little bit slightly disappointed. But I guess that's the attitude of when you see him on interviews and stuff, because he's always looking for improvements. That's a sign of a good fighter.
Yeah, I think he's really good. I think he really needs to give himself a pat on the back for that performance. Honestly, 2 years out against a tough opponent, give him that credit.
And he dominated every round. I think we've got the scores now.
A well-deserved win. Congratulations on Ofori's return. Now let's see what happens in the post-fight interview.
I think it's definitely time for him to go to the 6 and 8 rounds. What a fantastic performance.